Hi, welcome to product tutorial by Robojax. My name is Ahmad Shamshiri. I'm presenting this tutorial from Canada. In this tutorial, we are going to learn how we can use this Deek-Robot DTC1200 temperature. This is a device that you can set digitally the temperature and it will always keep it either by turning on a cooler or by turning on a heater. So the temperature is within the range that you select how much it can deviate. Operates either an AC version or DC version. I purchased the AC version because that will be the most useful one, but there is also a DC version of this available. Let's get started with this. I have no affiliation with Deek-Robot. I purchased this for $11.35 from AliExpress. When I did a search DTC1200 on AliExpress, these are all other stores that they are selling it at different prices. Also on eBay, when I did a search, these are the stores that they are selling it. I will provide you the link for the search result. When the package arrived, this is how I have received it. Intelligent temperature controller DTC1200, and this is the AC version, AC 110 to 220 volts. This is a digital heater and cooler controller from Deek-Robot, and the model is DTC1200. They offer it at AC or DC version. I selected AC because it was very easy and convenient to just plug it in, but there is a DC version in case if you need it. It's available at operating voltage of 12 to 72 volts. So with this one, you can control two separate devices, one for heating, one for cooling. And here is how you will operate and program this. For example, you want to set the temperature at 45 degrees Celsius, and you will set a value for the difference from this temperature. For example, if you can tolerate 7 degrees, for example, plus 7 degrees or minus 7 degrees, we can set that. So we will set a temperature at 45 degrees and 7 degrees difference. And that would cause it that if the temperature increases 7 degrees above this 45, then the cooler will start and it will cool down. If the temperature goes 7 degrees below 45, which is minus 7 from here, then the heater will turn on. Otherwise, it will always keep it with this. So we have two devices connected here, heater and cooler, and you will have a temperature automatically being controlled within the set range. But this is 110 and 220 volts, so it can work anywhere in the world. You can connect it directly to AC power. And the two terminal 1 and 2 will be connected to AC, and then here the two middle terminals are for heating control, the two right terminals are for cooling control. You can connect it to refrigerator or cooler, whatever you have, and it can be mounted on the panel with these two screws. The body of this one is flame resistant, it's compact, and we have only four buttons here, power, setting, and up and down, which I'm going to show you. And then we have large screen here that displays the value. With this temperature sensor, the two terminals, proper connector. You don't need any screw or anything, so just plug it in. And then in here we have six terminals here. The two left terminals are for power. For AC, you connect the two wires here. If it is DC, also you will connect it in here. And then these two pins are for heating control, and these two are for cooling control. Length of the module is 74.5 millimeters by 55.5 millimeters, and the depth is 32.9 millimeters. Exact center of the holes for the screw is 84.9 millimeters or 85 millimeters. Length of this cable is 100 centimeter or 1 meter. And if you're concerned with weight, it weighs 91.992 grams. Now let's have a look what is inside. So the panel is simple as that, and then when I push it from this side, it should pop out. Okay, And as you can see, the connector, and this is out. We have two sections. The connector that goes here for the LCD, for the LED screen, is in here. The power is connected at this point. It goes to the bridge rectifier and then to the switching power supply, which will control AC to desired the voltage here. And here we have two voltage regulators. This is 3.3 volts and this is 5 volts. The relays are rated for 110 volts load at 15 ampere. And here if you see it, and for 220 volts is 10 ampere. So for 220 volts times 10, 2200 watt or 2.2 kilowatts, the load can be connected. And here they put also some solder to increase the amount of current that this can handle. Let's open the panel. And here is the display that they've used. Two digits with C. Nothing special here. Now to prepare this, I'm using this AC wire. On this side, I've already cut it and prepared it. This is live and that's the neutral. Here they have not labeled it, which one is live and which is in neutral. I'm going to connect in pin 1 and pin 2. Here now the AC power is connected and you can see the device is turned on. If you have not connected the sensor, you will get EE. So let me connect it and then power it up again. Now it shows the temperature, no issue. And here for demonstration, I'm going to use this AC bulb as my load. And this is the plug where I can plug it in into AC outlet to turn this on. But at the middle, out of these two wires, I've cut the live or hot wire here. These two will be connected to the relay on the module. Job of the relay is to switch or connect it to turn it on and switch it off or disconnect it like that. The two wires for the cooler will be connected at these two terminals to switch it, and for the heater you will connect it at these two terminals to control it. And for this demonstration, I'm going to use this 12 volt DC bulb, which I'm going to power it via my power supply, and the switch will be at this point. So this is cooler, this will be connected to these two left terminal, and this will be my heater, which will be connected to the right terminals. Here, let's see how we can program this. I'm going to set the temperature at 45 degrees and I'm going to set the difference or tolerance at 7, which means plus 7 minus 7. First, if you want to turn this device off, press this power for more than 3 seconds, hold it and it will turn off. And if you want to turn it on, let's press and hold it and it will turn on. Right now the temperature sensor is connected. If you disconnect the temperature sensor and the wire is disconnected, you will see EE, so you know the temperature sensor is not connected. Let me connect it back. Just press the power and it will be resetted. After this is turned on, depending on the temperature and depending on the setting, either heat is on or cool is on, which I'm going to demonstrate practically. But to change it, first we have to set the temperature, which is F1. F1 is the temperature. This temperature is F1 and F2 is the difference, 7. We will set F2 at 7, we will set F1 at 45. Now press this S and hold it and you will see F1. You can now go F2, F3, F4 and it will return back to F1. To change it, you have to hold this with your hand and then with the arrow change it. Now if I release it, the screen will, within a few seconds, will time out and it goes here. So let me hold this F1, then hold this, and this is the temperature which I'm going to set to 45. Let's say hold it, so it's going to go faster. So this is my temperature, and if I release and press power, immediately it will exit. Now let's go set the F2, so press this, you will see it go up, that's F2. Now hold it to change F2. Now we are setting this to 7, so let's see what is the maximum. Hold this. We can set it to 10 degrees, or minimum of 0.3 degrees Celsius. So I'm setting it to 7. And now, if I press this, it will exit. F3 is the compressor delay time. Let me press it and hold it. So if you are not in F3, just hold F3. Now this is 1. I can go up to 10 minutes or what other value. This is a value where the compressor of refrigerators needs delay time, depending on the size and type. Sometimes it needs 5 minutes before turning it on again, so this will protect it. Right now I'm just setting it to 1 and exit. Now if I press this again, and now if I press this again, go 4 and hold it, this is the calibration. Or if you get some error in your temperature sensor that you have, and if it is deviating, so you can fix it here from minus 10 to 10 degrees. If I hold this, you will see that it can go up to 10, and if I go back, it can go up to minus 10 degrees. Right now I assume that the sensor is working properly. I'm just setting it to 7, to 0, so it is not adding. If you add some value, for example, if you're reading some value and the value is 2 degrees less, you can add 2 more, so it will compensate for that. I've shown you the wiring to connect an AC load or AC bulb, but I've connected to DC for demonstration purpose, so it can fit on the screen and you can see it larger. And this is the temperature sensor. Currently it shows the room temperature as 18.6 degrees, and if I press this button, that is showing the set temperature, which is 45 degrees. And because the room is below 45, the heater is now on, and this is a sign for the heater. You can see the heater, and that is my cooler, and I've written here the cooler or refrigerator. If I press this, you will see that I've set this to 7 degrees, which means from this 45, it can tolerate up to 7 degrees. If the room temperature is 7 degrees below this, which is 38, in the area where the sensor is, then the heater will turn on because it's below the expected value. That's why you see the heater. Now I'm going to use a heat gun to apply heat, and because it is set to 45 and the deviation is 7, 45 plus 7 is 52. When it reaches at 52, it's out of the bound and we have to cool it down. So that's why you will see that the cooler will turn on, and the cooler will keep the room temperature low until it reaches 45 or so. Then cooler will turn off. When it goes below, when it reaches 38 and below, then the heater will turn on. Let me show you now. I'm using this heat gun, Mastercraft from Canadian Tire. I will apply heat now here. So you will see the temperature is increasing. I'm slowing it down so you can see better. So 45 turned off. Now, right now we don't need any cooler or heater because our setting temperature is 45, and it is not 7 degrees above, not 7 degrees below. For that reason, we are within the range, so it is operating without heater or cooler. Now I will increase the temperature so you will see that 45 plus 7, 52. At 52, the cooler should start working and it will cool it down. And because here the compressor time is set to 1 minute, that is the minimum. If I press this, that is a F3, press and hold, and then down here F3, and then if I hold it, it says 2, let's make it 1. When it is set here to 1 minute, then the compressor does not start immediately. It will wait 1 minute before turning it on. So that cooler, when the temperature reaches at 52, after 1 minute, if it is above 52, the cooler will turn on. Let me show you now. So now 50, now so from this moment I have to keep it above 52, so I will blow some air. I'm showing you the countdown of time so you can see that I will keep it for at least 1 minute above 52. When 1 minute passes, then it will turn on. And now, as you can see, the cooler is turned on. Now, when it reaches, so if I want this to go faster, I can hold it with my hand to reduce the temperature very quickly. When it reaches around 45, the cooler will turn off. So the cooler is now turned off. If it goes 45 minus 7, which is 38, then the heater will turn on. So the heat will increase and will always keep it at 45. Now you'll see at 38, this will turn on. So the heater turned on. For conclusion, I will say that I can say that this Deek-Robot DTC1200 is very easy to use, compact, user friendly with few switches, and the features are amazing. In case if you have this such application that you want to keep the temperature specifically steady at certain value with controlling heater and cooler, definitely I would suggest this. I have no affiliation, so it was just my personal opinion. Thank you for watching tutorial from Robojax. This was how to use DTC1200 temperature control from Deek-Robot. If you like this video and learned something, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. If you want to get updates of my upcoming videos, make sure to subscribe. Hi, welcome to product tutorial by Robojax. My name is Ahmad Shamshiri. I'm presenting this tutorial from Canada. In this tutorial, we are going to learn how we can use this Deek-Robot DTS. In this tutorial,